boys. We're on.
Welcome home. This is the Residency Podcast. I am Jeff Tomasic with Drew Belcher and Lo Raven.
Yes, sir.
Bringing you the biggest guests and stories in entertainment, business, pop culture, and sports from our studio on the Las Vegas Strip inside the Mandalay Bay. Make sure to subscribe on Apple, Spotify, and YouTube. This episode is brought to you by Mandalay Bay. The man, the myth, the legend, Grammy Award winning Usher continues his residency in August at Dolby Live Theater at Park MGM. With tons of dates to choose from, make sure to check it out. Plus, none other than Red Hot Chili Peppers will be performing at Allegiant Stadium.
Nice.
Special guest, The Strokes, is going to be there on August 3rd. That's a massive checklist you have to go see. And the Las Vegas Aces has completely taken over the city with their games at Michelob Ultra Arena. So make sure to go get tickets to any of their upcoming home games at Mandalay Bay. As always, come say what's up at our studio inside the Mandalay Bay Sportsbook. Say what's up. Bang on the glass. We're ready for you.
Knock on the windows, dude.
Yes, we need it. Hype us up. We got another episode today.
Here we go.
This should be fun. Got a lot coming today. Today we have entrepreneur, fitness superstar, and cover model, Whitney Johns. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Are you energized in this Vegas atmosphere?
Just got to Vegas this morning. I'm like, let's go, baby.
Okay, so you're fresh on the trip then.
Yes.
So we got you in the beginning.
Not the tail end.
You don't want the tail end.
Sunday or Monday, it'd be a different story. Yeah. Different enthusiasm levels.
So what's on the docket? What are we doing? Are we partying? Are we eating? Are we gambling?
Yes, I have been, to be totally upfront, super burned out with work. And I'm like, it's a friend's reunion. Literally a friend from college, like my best guy friends from college. Where, funny story, I grew up Mormon. Okay. You'd never guess. They kicked me out a long time ago. And I went to BYU for a couple of years, and we were kind of like the Mormons that would escape to Vegas every weekend to get away from Mormonville.
Is that a crew? Is that a group?
We was very bonding.
Yeah, okay, very much so.
It was like we were really bonded and tight knit, and he was a big, you know, Vegas guy and got really hooked up. So we haven't seen each other in probably a decade. So this is like a reunion, and I brought a couple girlfriends with me too, and my boyfriend, and we're doing the thing. I was like, I'm gonna maybe shoot a little content while I'm here, and this podcast is, I'm counting as work.
Checking this off the list.
I'm like, this is the write-off.
Yeah.
And now I'm getting whammered.
For sure. Gotta
be all solidified for the accountants. I was there. We shot content.
I worked. I have the video.
I worked.
Yeah, off the rip. And again, the beginning. So now you don't have to worry about anything.
Yeah,
exactly.
Can we go back to growing up Mormon real quick? When, we had no idea about this. How did this work out? How did this start and stop?
Okay, so I grew up in Idaho, Boise, Idaho.
Okay.
Between Boise, Idaho and Utah is kind of where my family background is from. And I was pretty good at playing the rules, but I always kind of could tell, even as a young kid, you know how as a kid you can even tell like if something doesn't resonate with your soul.
Sure.
You don't even know who you are yet at that point, but you're just like, this don't feel right though. But I'm actually in a lot of ways really grateful I grew up that way. There was a lot of really good values that I took from it. The nicest people in the world. I have nothing bad to say about Mormon people. And half my family is still Mormon. It's great for them. But I was just a different breed. I think spirituality is a very individual thing. And I kind of knew that gut instinct from a young age. And then once I went to college and I found myself like surrounded by only that culture, and I was like, what am I doing? I was like smoking pot, like blowing it out the window, praying that my roommates weren't going to smell it and like tell on me. And I'm like, I'm an adult. Like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
Like, why am I doing this? So I finally, you know, escaped and figured out and went on a whole venture of like, okay, try everything. And I did.
Good.
That was fun.
Yeah, you live a little.
Yeah.
College.
And then, college. And then I kind of figured out, okay, like what really aligns with my soul spiritually. And I'm very, very glad I went through that experience. I think it teaches you at a young age, like you have to break barriers and boundaries of like what people are telling you you're supposed to be. And like, you can't give a fuck about what they're trying to place on you. You have to be yourself. Like, it's not worth it. It's not worth it to pretend.
Especially you're born into it and you don't really have a choice. You feel like you don't, right?
Well, and it's totally... In a lot of those, and I think this happens with a lot of religion too, and just certain cultures, it's like you get cast out in that culture.
Sure.
So it's not just about you left the church, you left your entire community and they are now like, don't want anything to do with you. So you really do have to learn how to have a backbone and just be like, you know what though? Like, it's not worth it.
How did your family take it?
My family's really awesome.
Cool.
And they're awesome. Yeah, they were really, they were, of course I got some pushback, but I think they knew after 21 years of living with me that I do what I'm going to do.
This is coming.
Like, you all can't right. really tell.
Not a curveball at all.
Oh, we knew.
Right? Like, yeah. It's like a coming out. They're like, yeah, we knew a long time ago.
Yeah, we
honey.
Knew. Go ahead. We planned on
you're
this.
You're all going to hell. We all know that.
When you, oh, man. I don't know about that. But when you leave Mormonism, is there like something formal?
You know, like sign paperwork and
you
like,
do?
There is for some. I think if it's like, I didn't go through the formal process where I'm like, have my name removed from the records, because that is a thing.
Really?
If you, and I think like if you are a practicing Mormon and you end up, there's certain sins that if you do them,
you're
then you are literally like asked to leave, or your names are removed from the records or whatever. I still have like some of the missionaries like calling me like, hey, you want to come back? I'm like, please lose my number.
No, I don't want to. What's the weirdest spam call of all time? Yeah, yeah. Hey, like, just checking in.
I would have taken it from Visa. Oh. No, just kidding. And I'll still go to church with my mother, and I have a lot of respect for the, you know, values. And for some people, it's a great thing. You know, it's a good thing in their life, but I'm like, it wasn't for me. I'm not into the shaming and the guilt.
Sure.
The fear tactics is like not a vibe
not
for
a vibe
me.
At all.
It's not my thing. So yeah.
What's the college version of Mormon? Like the BYU, how is BYU like halfway between normal life and Mormon life?
Oh,
like
man.
Somewhere in the middle?
Oh, I have so many stories.
Huge
well,
party school though.
Well,
it's got to be. By design too, I bet.
It's got to be.
It's a lot of like underground parties that you can find for sure. Or you could be like my degenerate friends and I, where we would just escape to Vegas all the time. Or yeah. Go to Salt Lake City clubs.
Salt Lake City,
baby.
Yeah, yeah, go. Sure. But it's a lot of like, you know, you have to check in with your bishop, which is the leader of your church, you know, every, I think, quarter, and just make sure that you're still worthy to go to school there, which I was always like, huh? And why are we asking questions about like my sexual activity? And like, it was just a lot. So there's a lot of like, this is one thing that I didn't like about it, is because you see a lot of people having to, out of necessity, survival, and like, I don't want to get kicked out of school, having to lie and pretend that they're something that they're not, and like pretending that they're leading these lives. That comes with a lot of shame, right?
Sure.
And like a lot of just like, then it can take on a whole other like secretive life, right?
Yeah.
That's how people... Yeah. Get like addictions and like really dark, because they can't talk to anybody about who they are.
And they don't want to. They don't
right.
feel like, yeah.
So I saw a lot of the like dark side of that, like shame and what it does to a person. And I was like, nah, I can't do this anymore. So
it takes a lot of the enjoyment out of actually college in general.
Totally.
A bit,
I'm like,
yourself.
You don't even can't
enjoy
even live your
yourself.
Life. Like
yeah.
have the college experience and have a drink and like go to a party. And they had their versions of that. And I really don't mean to be like shitting on the Mormon church or whatever.
Go for it. Do whatever you want.
But yeah, it was just, it's like, this isn't real life. It just felt like I was like trapped in this weird bubble that was like a Stepford Wives version of like, and not me. So
how
yeah.
real are the TV shows on TV? Because like my girl watches this one show. I don't know the name of it, but it's on like maybe AMC or some shit. I'm sure.
Is
you
it
guys
called
have
Big Love? Like
I'm not sure, but it's like I'm assuming it's maybe about Mormonism. But dude, these guys have like multiple wives and they're all chill about it. And it's kind of weird, but also extremely
yeah.
fascinating.
The
is that real?
He's all,
really
can we get that reinstated?
Does this crossover outside of BYU?
Is it real?
How do we talk my girlfriend into getting
yeah,
down
it's
with
a thing though, right?
No. Polygamy is a different sect. So that's how the Mormon religion started, is polygamy, which
okay.
multiple wives.
Sure.
And it's really for the purpose of like multiplying and replenishing the earth with more yeah. Mormon people.
Right.
Which I was like, can I do that with like 8 husbands? Because
yeah.
I have a lot of needs.
Sure.
And
sure.
why can't it work on the reverse?
Understandable.
So, how did that go?
It got shut down
pretty
quick. But and then at some point it became illegal, and then they kind of outlawed that from the Mormon church even. So then the polygamists actually created their own sect.
Got
so
it.
That's not the Mormonism that I was involved in. Yeah. But, you know, I was like, I would love to see how that would play out on the other side.
For sure.
But also still sheltering the kids from like technology and everything. That's still
yeah,
a thing?
Yeah. Okay. There are people that still live that
there's,
life.
There's always more extreme cases of all of it, right?
For you sure. Know
yeah. 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 Cause this show is crazy. And the kids just
and it's almost
grew
like
up
an
now.
Amish life.
Yeah.
Type
I don't know the name. Fuck.
This is the most extreme version of that's why I got a TV show. It's not the normal, grew up yeah. not the normal BYU kids.
Yeah. And then they all move to like LA and they're going fucking wild right now.
Right.
They're all partying. Well, they're all smoking.
That's the thing is like, I always tell my buddies when they're like, oh my God, I'm like dating this girl. She used to be Mormon. I was like, she's a freak. Huh?
Yeah, dude. Yeah, dude. Yeah, they are.
Wild.
Dude, this is why you can't corral people because they just go the
them.
Other extreme yeah, afterwards. Sure.
No, totally.
You have to slowly introduce things. You can't cut them off from stuff yeah. and then let them go to college. I'm sure they're going to be just fine. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Going to Salt Lake
They'll
next.
They'll balance out at some point.
Go to
He's
Salt
like,
Lake.
I'm going to move to Sundance Salt Lake.
When?
Yo, Salt Lake, everything Salt Lake like closes like at like midnight or something, doesn't it?
I mean, there's really weird. I don't know about
and
the
And you
curfew.
Can't you can't have like a drinking establishment like close to the churches, and there's churches everywhere all
yes,
over Salt Lake.
And yeah. there's like really weird liquor laws there where you the can't cupboard. Get like even like the beer is like a lower all the alcohol in Utah is basically like a
lower
percentage
of
alcohol. So you can
yeah.
be like taking shots and you're like, I'm not drunk yet. Like it's so frustrating.
1% alcohol.
But I think with the hours that they do allow it to take place. They make worth of those hours, you know.
They go
right.
hard.
Oh,
go
yeah.
hard.
They go hard.
BYU like, low. I recommend go check it out. You should check it out.
I've been.
Check
Salt
it out. There we go.
Salt,
yeah,
Lake,
Salt Lake
is
Lake.
Actually like kind of a fun town Park now, City. And I think it can be credited to like the suppression that happened, and then like the breakout,
the boom,
the breakout.
Like,
yeah,
I was part
yeah.
of that.
The break.
But, like,
BYU breakout.
The revolution.
Cue
of
the
Salt
intro
Lake
song.
City.
Yeah, for sure.
You need both. You need both.
I was doing God's work. Helping.
100%.
Well, we all appreciate
we appreciate that. Thank
we
you
all
so
appreciate
much.
It. This is officially a BYU recruiting podcast now.
You know, not sponsored, but can be sponsored.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. So now that we've established that, we're definitely going to get
background.
Some fun stories out of you and some yeah, good background.
That was sure. not on the agenda.
Yeah, that was on the agenda. It was great. I love hearing just the secrets off the rip.
I love it.
Solid icebreaker. Can we hear like a crazy Vegas story that you have? Because this is a Las Vegas podcast.
God, speaking of shame.
There we go.
Shame.
We've
shame.
All been there.
Shame. We're just going to start the podcast.
Yeah,
with all
this
the
is
shameful.
An icebreaker.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. I mean... There's those times where you like are stumbling out of the strip club at 7 a.m. and you're like, I spent way too much money
yes.
and we are such losers.
Been there.
Like the sun is coming up. Like I need to get my life together. But you're also like, that was a good night.
That was worth it.
That was a great
it.
Morning. Yeah, for
that
sure.
That was a good, yeah, it was a marathon
we
day.
We appreciate those nights.
Yeah. I mean, you got to do it. In Vegas, it's like, you got to have fun.
See, this if you move here, big if. By the way, breaking news, right. everyone.
Hey.
When he's possibly moving to Las Vegas.
It's an option.
It is an option.
Is it something?
And if it happens, we are taking
let
at
me
least
know.
20%
Send
of credit.
A, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
We helped.
So I'm doing a poll. Is Vegas a good option?
Don't
I'm
ask them to send you DMs because they're wild.
They're like, this is why you should
yeah,
have
it's an open invitation.
Yeah,
because
you just see Vegas and enter, then the real question. Yeah, yeah. You know what I mean?
Well, I do feel like it's kind of interesting because everyone's migrating out of the really big cities and going into some of these smaller ones that are now becoming big cities.
Sure.
And I came from LA.
You call
and
it a small
I,
city.
Well, no.
What are you trying to say?
It's like a, you know,
it is.
It's
we're
like
start,
a A-minus team.
We're a startup.
Yeah, yeah, we're a startup. We're a startup. We're climbing. We're climbing. We're climbing.
And so, but then it's like, is it just going to all become, it's like Florida's, everybody's migrating to Florida, Vegas, Arizona. Now, are those going to become like the
LA's.
Nightmare and clusterfuck that LA was? Because I left for a reason.
Sure.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know? So
no, like know. Even Vegas now as it grows, like jokingly, people from LA to come visit, right? I actually used to have a restaurant off the strip and I used to say, hey, come visit me, try the restaurants in Summerlin. Like, oh, it's like 20 minutes away. Don't worry about it. It's kind of far. They're like, what are you talking about? They're like from Los Angeles. Like everything
like
is 30 minutes away.
Minutes.
So like
yeah.
that's not an inconvenience whatsoever.
Totally.
In Vegas,
yeah.
do it. Our version of like slam, busy traffic, uncontrollable is like your, in LA's like, perfectly smooth day.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Ours yeah. is 15 minutes. It's too far.
Yeah.
That's the thing about Vegas.
We're a couple million people away, so we're fine. yeah. Like, don't
it,
worry.
It feels like convenience is like the name of the game here, which
sure.
is nice.
The
it's
one
like
thing,
everything is so accessible. Like, and it's not
And it's open late. Everything here yeah. is open super late. So mm-hmm. if you want to get a really nice meal at 11 p.m., you're perfectly
exactly.
can get one on the strip.
And by the way, off the strip is very like normal, suburban, quiet,
right.
nice
quiet.
Life. And you yeah. just have the strip. 15, 10 minutes away
right.
if you want it.
If
you,
you
don't
want
to
dip
it,
in,
you're good.
Yeah. Real neighborhoods,
go to a
park,
all
the
hang
cool
with
shit.
Your dog, do your thing.
I really feel like I'm, my boyfriend said to me the other day, he's like, you really are like 80 years old, because I'm like, I really feel like a snowbird where I'm like, can I go to the desert in the winter and then like go to the, you know, have the mountains in the summer, because I love my place in Denver, but it's like,
I don't think that's called 80. That's called rich.
Yeah, so you just, yeah, you want, I was just gonna say.
So you want multiple houses. You want vacation homes. Sure. That's not 80. That's rich. That's rich.
Yeah, yeah. I'm like,
I don't know what this fall. Is. I want this house in Vail, like, and one in the beach. We have, and I want like this plane to go there, but I don't want anyone else to be on it.
How do we make that happen?
It's called rich.
Yes, rich. Got it. Yeah. Solving your problem is fast.
Hey, listen, yeah, yeah. I'm okay with rich.
Okay, perfect. Perfect. Rich and not 80. And you look great for 80, by the way. So
there you go.
Congratulations. Everything leading into supplements. You know,
That's a testament. Walking billboard.
Right?
Truly 80.
One, yes.
But with Whitney John's nutrition, you
all
can
of this is true, people.
All
no, there's zero fine print here. All right, let's talk about fitness industry really quick.
Yeah.
We want to go into this. What is a secret about the fitness industry that outsiders really would not know?
My biggest thing that I've found with the fitness industry, and one of the reasons why, honestly, I got into coaching in my supplement line was because, like, I was in the bodybuilding world and I was in, like, the old school fitness world. There's a lot of really unhealthy, really unsustainable practices that they preach in the fitness industry, and a lot of just, like, shit that's being sold and misinformation that is really damaging to people's health, right?
Sure.
So it's like, you know, there's aesthetics fitness, and then there's like health and how long are you going to be able to maintain the aesthetic, because you might be able to do crash diets and lose the weight and whatever, lean down, but your body's like falling apart on the inside, right? So, and I saw that a lot on, like, I got my pro card in the bodybuilding world and I was like, I'm out, like, I gotta go, because it was so extreme and it was so damaging. This is why you see competitors that will yo-yo. They'll go on stage, they look amazing, right? And then they'll go off season and they blow up.
So massive swing.
Yep. Major blow up, or they'll get just super depressed. Their hormones are crashed. Like, and that's because of the extreme. You have to take more of a sustainable approach to it. And you really have to prioritize things like your hormone health, your gut health, your mental health. Because if those aren't in check, like, what is the point, right? Like, you can lose weight, get lean, but you're a nightmare.
Yeah.
And so, like, I dealt with that too, coming off competing. Like, my hormones were terrible. I was dealing with all kinds of mental health issues. And a lot of it was because of the damage that I did because of these extreme measures. And so I think that's the biggest thing, is there's so much in marketing in the fitness world. And it's like, these ingredients are like really toxic for you, or really bad for your gut, or really just, you know, like, really bad on your adrenals in general. So I think that's my biggest beef about the fitness industry, is I just wish there was more sustainable stuff being taught. And there actually is now a lot more than there was. You know, I've been in the game for a minute.
Well, especially social media, like, how much trash, fitness trash, right, is being pushed,
especially
on social media
now, right, like,
now.
TikTok.
Totally.
Dude, if you get a shredded physique, start putting out some content, all these younger kids, everybody will look up to you, and you say, hey, I got this way by taking this supplement or that supplement.
Right.
The majority of it, bullshit.
Right. I know. And that's the thing. And like, I've done promo deals and sponsored by different companies too. And, you know, it's so saturated. So it's almost like, and it is a business at the end of the day.
Sure.
So it's, I'm like a moneymaker at the end of the day. I'm like an entrepreneur. I'm like, let's make fucking money. But I'm also like, but there's still a way to make money and like make it very good for people too. Mm-hmm. So there's always that line to that you're having to toe of, you know, and even in the fitness industry, it's like, even with my own content, I struggle with this all the time. I'm like, am I contributing to the mental health, like, struggle of, you know, impossible standards that people are trying, or the comparison that people I get that too. Like, we all look at social media and we're like, my life sucks. Like,
for sure. God damn it, my life sucks.
Like, oh my God, like, I am not doing it.
Yeah, they're perfect. He's perfect. She's perfect.
Yeah. And everyone does it. It doesn't matter. I've found, like, it doesn't matter how successful you are, how, like, sound mind you are. Everyone fucking falls into this trap, because it's just, we're all human. And so that's the other thing, is like, you know, my photo shoots that I put out, I love doing photo shoots. I love celebrating my hard work. Like, I put a lot of work into my, but I don't, look like a fucking goddess all the time, or, you know, in my photo shoots, like, I look like shit half the time. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, it's like, that's, it's just, don't take what you see as 100% truth. It's just, there's always like smoke and mirrors, and that's part of the business, but like, don't take it to heart and don't take it personal and don't take it like, I am not enough because this person's Photoshop is better than mine.
Sure.
You know, that's my biggest thing.
Also touching on going back to the fact that people don't look like that year round.
No.
You know, like I was super heavily into the bodybuilding community maybe 10 years ago. I'm 35. So maybe actually 14 years ago, I was 250 pounds, shredded.
Nice.
Looked fantastic on a ton of steroids.
Right.
And I mean, an abnormal amount. Looked great, but not healthy. Right. Being that big and lean year round and vascular and eating that amount of food, it's not healthy. I had horrible sleep apnea. I got a bad hernia from squatting so much weight. Went to go get surgery, had blood work done. The doctor was like, hey, you have to come off all that shit.
Hey, I was like, what's wrong?
I was like, what shit? I was like, what shit? I'm on
like, what do you mean? I don't know what you're talking about.
He was like, yeah, stop.
It's all here on the paper.
But yeah, it's not healthy. It's not a healthy lifestyle at that level.
Yes.
But that was like bodybuilding, abusing.
And it's like,
I was an abuser.
Well, there it is. We all do it at different times.
It's okay. But
I think it's like, it's great. I do think, again, it's not that the bodybuilding world is terrible. I always tell clients, like, use it as a goal. Like, it's a great way to learn. I learned so much discipline from my bodybuilding days and how to like dial in for shoots that I still use those tools all the time. And it really helped kick off my career in a lot of ways, but it's like, take the good and then like totally leave the bad, but leave the extreme. That's my thing.
There's so many areas of the fitness industry outside of bodybuilding that you can be successful in if you don't want to do that. Yeah,
I mean, bodybuilding
world, right?
Bodybuilders are broke as fuck.
That was the only way to make money back in the day was traditional bodybuilding. Sort of, and even that was like maybe 200,000-300,000 a year.
There's so many other ways.
There's influencers on TikTok making that a month.
Oh yeah. There's little 8-year-olds on YouTube that are making it. Like,
crushing it.
Yeah.
You fucking suck. Well,
how did you get it, right? Like, yeah, should have started at 8. Yeah. On like what, MySpace? So how did you pivot then from being, or what is the biggest difference from you having like these supplement deals to starting your own company? Like that's a massive leap, by the way, a lot of work, not guaranteed.
Yeah.
Way easier to just take the easy bag, make a video, post a photo and bounce. Yeah.
Totally. Well, I knew I wanted to do it for a long time and I really was, I just got really selective with the deals that I started taking on too.
Yeah.
As I got into it, I was like, okay, like I don't also want to be like a walking billboard either. I know I want to do my own line of supplements. I know I want to do my own products. I know I want to do my own apparel at some point. So really just starting to like, okay, get really strategic about your brand, the messaging and the story that it tells. And I hired coaches. Like I'm big on like, I'm a coach, but I'm also like, I'm a coach because I have had so many coaches that I've invested a ton of money in coaching, mentoring, and just like teach me the skills. And I think that as humans, we need that. Like in any venue that you want to get better at, you need a coach. You need someone that's been there before you, because if not, why not just like save yourself a lot of time and trouble? So I learned a lot of the ways of like how to shape the story of my brand, where I really wanted it to go, what really was resonating with the clients that were drawn to me, because you end up finding like a certain prototype of client is like drawn to me or to anyone. It's like, who am I resonating with?
Who are you resonating with?
What do they really need? My clients are badass females that are like not perfect. They are not trying to be the perfect housewife, mom. They are doing their best and they're ballsy in their own way. They have their own struggles with confidence, but they want to feel good. They want to feel empowered. They want to feel sexy. I like with my brand, like I show skin. I'm not like the typical, I guess, like commercial fitness look, right?
Sure.
So, and I had a lot of issues, like struggles with that too, coming up too. It was like, I didn't get hired by a lot of fitness modeling agencies because they're like, you're not the look. Like, you're not like the kind of cookie cutter look. You're too sexy. You've got boobs and an ass and too many muscles. And it's like, so I had to find my own kind of way. And I think that that's the clients that I resonate with as well, is like the ones that are a little bit out of the box in terms of like the typical perfect woman, but also like really badass ladies. Sure. Yeah. So. And I work with a lot of guys too that are just real and we expect
some samples now, you know what I mean? Yeah. See what's going.
We're trying to step it up a little bit. That heart rate up, you know
guys,
what I mean?
Guys, we're going.
Jeff said, we're real guys.
Here we out
it.
Here.
No, but I'm actually really proud of the people that gravitate towards me. And I think that comes from like just trying to continually be authentic in your messaging and like authentic in who you are.
So how's it doing?
How you're showing up. Good. Yeah. It's been great. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the next step? Like, what's the next big thing that's happening?
Well, I have like 3 products on the docket that I'm building the line out for.
Okay.
And one is a gut health product that I'm really excited about. That's kind of like, I'm very nerdy about that because I think it helps in every way and solves so many problems. It's
a
hot topic.
Are you a fan of kombucha?
Gut health.
I am.
We love kombucha.
Kombucha.
Are you?
Yeah. We're big kombucha guys.
Okay. Have you ever tried kombucha with alcohol?
Yeah. There's hard kombuchas out there.
Hard kombucha.
Well, okay, by the way, kombucha with no alcohol is just like embers. Thick juice.
Yeah. We don't drink it without alcohol.
Well, have you had it with like tequila and kombucha?
Oh, no. Like, I had the packaged ones.
A mixer.
No.
I'm telling you, do a mixer. It is fabulous. And you also feel like you're like not doing as much damage.
It's healthy. Come on.
Brain trick.
It's
got health. Brain trick.
And canceling out the alcohol.
Bad for liver, good for the other part of the gut.
This is much starting at square one.
Yeah,
for sure.
As long as that's healthy packaging, it this weekend, like, it's okay.
I'm very proud of you guys that you're on the kombucha train.
Oh, yeah. We're big on the kombucha. Yeah. Ladies, booch for the cooch. Yeah. 100%.
We're
pH
supportive.
Yeah, we're food beverage forward. Don't worry. We got this.
All right. So gut health. What else?
Gut health, hormone health is a big one for me. And then I have my brain activate. I meant to bring you guys.
The nootropics?
The nootropics.
Fuck, we're big on all that, dude.
I should have brought you. I actually had three ready to go for you guys.
Yeah,
very smart
on
the hill here.
Well, yeah, this nootropics product, it has ketones, nootropics, and it's really good for just fat burning and energy and focus. But it's non-caffeinated, the version that I have right now, but I have a caffeinated version coming out, which is like, it's just like a superpower. And I'm really excited about
that. How much caffeine is in one pill?
It's only like 75 milligrams.
That's not bad. That's like a Red Bull.
And it's a gel pack, actually. Ooh, so like it's like a totally exclusive formula too, which I'm very excited.
I like that. All these energy drinks now, like you go having like 350 milligrams of caffeine.
I like it though. I like the aggressiveness. I feel like the jitterish.
I crashed.
Coming from the guy who was abusing steroids.
And has a mullet on the verge of like shitting your pants.
I crashed. Dying, shaking. We both have kids now though. So when I come to later at night and then I have a big energy drink earlier in the day and then I finally put my kid to bed, I'm like, I just smoke crashed. Off the side of the earth.
Just
like I'm
face
dead.
Down.
Like no, it's 7:45. It's a wrap.
Well, and that's the thing is, even if it's like 300 milligrams of caffeine, like if you can go 200 or less a day, you're doing a lot more for your adrenals. So if you can find other ways, it's one of the reasons why I'll put my nootropics product with coffee as a creamer too. But it's like, if you can minimize.
You're putting caffeine pills, your caffeine in the coffee?
It's a gel powder.
Now we're talking.
Well, there's a gel pack and there's a powder. And the powder you use as like a creamer in your coffee.
This is sick.
So,
now I like this. Caffeinated creamer in my coffee. Let's fucking go.
I love
it supercharges your brain so you don't need as much caffeine and you feel like you almost like took a look. Like a little half Adderall. You know?
Like, throw it in there.
But
throw
you're not doing the damage. Sure. So I feel like
our sample box has got a lot bigger, guys. Sample palettes coming soon.
I love it.
You
ever tried butter in your coffee?
It's produced in Vegas, right?
Bulletproof. Bulletproof.
I used to be the biggest bulletproof coffee fan. I loved that. I was religious about it.
They thought I was crazy about it.
I loved it. See? And it because it, but you know why? It's because those healthy fats. Those act as like almost like a nootropic.
Complete
to your brain.
Placebo effect. You guys are bananas.
No, I promise. And it satiates you all day. You're good.
Sicko butter, keto butter coffee in the morning. Yeah, you don't care what anyone says. You can't prove me that that's happening, right?
I use MCT oils. Mine, I feel like, is a lot more clean.
It's not
like super greasy. Like butter.
You have this 30.
It's not butter.
Bulletproof is a little like. Almost like a greasy point.
Oh yeah, you get that film on top. Yeah, that bacon grease.
Yeah,
he
it's
loves
a little
it.
Much.
He loves that. Yes,
it's too much.
Like, give me all the grease.
It's too much.
There are some benefits.
Well, look, that's amazing. By the way, congratulations. It's really difficult. We all understand the difficulty between idea and turning into a real business.
Yeah.
So
thank you
that's
so much.
Obviously, a massive difficulty, and then people are obviously liking it. More lines means more people are buying.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic.
That's great.
We like
Thank
that.
Thank you so much.
We like yeah. that. We're excited to be your guinea pigs.
Yeah.
All right.
So he's like, you're sending me a package.
Yeah, let's go. No, we love trying.
I honestly will.
You know what's fun is trying stuff.
Yeah, for
I'm
sure.
always down to try stuff. You
no
know?
Matter what it is.
Once you get older,
why not?
When you're younger, you're like, I don't need shit. I'm like I'm so like everything works so well.
Yeah, I'm a superhero.
And then you get in your 30s, and then nothing fucking works.
Yeah,
right? Someone's like brain health, gut health. You're like, send it to me. I need it all.
Let me try.
I need toes to top of the head health. Yes. Give me whatever you got. You
know we need it, man. We're there.
Break it down.
Seriously, I know.
All right, we wanted to go back to the fitness news real quick. We had a question for you because you were talking about posing and all of that.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're a confident person and you're able to do this. Mm-hmm. What is it like to actually pose naked for a magazine? Like, what's the process?
You know, well, usually, okay, so I've been in the modeling game long enough to where I don't really work with photographers that I don't already have either worked with already or mm-hmm. has been vetted by other models that I know in the industry or know that they're a professional. So there's already that layer. I think a lot of new models, it's like, you kind of don't know
risky,
what you're getting
sure.
into.
Yeah.
Yet.
For sure.
So I've been doing it for so long. That has gone away for me, like the nerves. And I'm like, I usually end up feeling comfortable. And honestly, photographers, the most successful photographers that I know that are usually because they're not weirdos and not
sure.
creeps and
yeah.
they've been vetted, right? So one. Two, a couple shots of tequila always help.
There's a secret.
That's the secret.
When's the last time you're sober in front of a stranger?
Add kombucha.
Yeah,
add
helps.
Kombucha.
That always helps. At least cancel sure. out the damage. And I do think that you just have to get into your own, like you really have to get present with yourself, your comfortability, your senses, like come back to the moment. Because if you're in your head, it shows in a photo shoot. Like mm. on the cameras, you can read it all day. If you're uncomfortable with something,
yeah,
no, or you're for sure. not feeling it, or you're not feeling confident, it's all over your face. Like they'll just delete the whole shoot.
Sure.
So you have to kind of have your own process of like, how do I loosen up and feel comfortable and get
mentally
into my
prepared.
Body? Yeah. Whether that's like, hey, I need to put this playlist on, or you got to do what you got to do sensorially to really get yourself in that place of comfort. But also it's like, I feel like I was a born nudist.
Sure. Yeah,
it's
we'll
one of the reasons
that.
Why the Mormon church yeah. didn't really work out well yeah. for me.
I was going to say, you're a born Mormon.
Wait a minute.
You became a nudist.
Yeah. It was nature, not nurture. Trust me. So I think that I've just always been a little more free spirited. And that's one of the reasons why I love strip clubs. It's like, I have no problem with nudity. I'm
right.
like, the body is beautiful. I mean, many of them are, some are not, but the body is beautiful. And it's like, also the work that I put into my body is
sure.
it really is sort of like, this is a celebration of that.
For
what
sure.
is the point of all this discipline if I can't
be proud of it?
And some people take issue with, you know, I never do like full nudity or anything like that.
Right.
I do a lot of implied or if whatever, but it's like, I have no moral dilemma about showing my body in a way that's beautiful and artistic. You know what I mean? So yeah, I guess.
I mean, you can't, by the way, everyone's going to hate whatever you do, no matter what.
Yeah,
so
you can't
as well do exactly what you're comfortable with. I've always found that interesting, like how big the team is or what's going on and how comfortable you have to be with. Because the photographer's one thing, right? But you have the lighting guy, the managers, the PR
yes.
people, the makeup people,
the
hairdressers,
the, hair, yeah,
the whole
everything.
Thing. And
yes.
you have these like 15, 20 people around in this moment. And this is more just coming from people who have no clue what it's like to do a photo shoot.
For sure.
Right.
I've never posed naked.
So
right.
you know
Hold
what I'm saying? You can't search. There's no Google out there. So for this,
totally.
So what that really is actually like dealing with that type of like imagine this scenario, just
naked,
no doubt.
Naked.
I think that's another thing though, is when they're working professionals, this is the other thing that I've.
Just not weird for them at all. Zero.
It's not.
It's like a doctor.
That's the other thing. Like photographers literally see, it's not sexy. Like they literally zoom in on your zits and like your blemishes and your like bikini line bumps and like, it's not hot.
Sure.
Like, so they're not looking at it as a sexual thing. It's literally like, let's get the fucking job done and get
right.
the shot. I think it comes down to, are you working as a professional or are you kind of just sticking around and having fun?
Standing out.
Which, you know, there's there's no problem with being fun and creative either. But it's also like, once you get seasoned enough, you're like, we got to get the shot. Like, so whatever it takes, like shoots are not a fun, glamorous process for the most part. I mean, they can be really fun, but you are also like, you're hungry.
It's a long run for a very specific moment.
It's usually cold. Like you're like, I'm done. Like, can I eat now? And like,
now smile.
So yeah. And then you have to like, so it is sort of like, let's get this done and let's get the shot. And I mean, I guess it kind of depends on what you're doing it for.
That's cool. Yeah. If it's cold, count me out. I'm out.
He's like,
especially in Vail.
Shrinking.
We're already, you know what I mean? You can't be cold too, you know? Yeah. Gone.
Booked this way. Sorry. No. Now that I think about it out loud, it's kind of like a doctor, right? Like, they're like totally. A doctor where you go into Vegas, exactly. It's like nothing, next one, go on.
Exactly.
I get that. That makes a lot more sense now. And I'm sure, assumably, after you do one or two or three, you've been around even more. It's just like, no big deal.
Totally.
Ain't no thing.
Yeah.
Okay. I love that. Can I ask another question? Kind of like a little bit off topic.
Yeah.
I was looking through your social media,
mm-hmm.
and this is a general question that I've seen all over social media now. What is the big thing with crystals?
Rocks?
I gotta know.
The crystals.
Yeah.
Well,
you're into it.
Are they charged?
If you know, you know.
Are they charged?
You know, you have to charge them.
You have to charge them.
The sun charges them.
And the moon.
So, well, I just recently went to Sedona, and I mean, I've been a couple times. It kind of depends on if you're into like the healing woo-woo stuff or not.
Sure.
Okay, can you go back? You said you just went to Sedona. Is that like the
crystal capital? Crystal headquarters?
It actually kind of is.
That's like, the crystal capital?
Do we go mining there?
Not necessarily. They do have a lot of like where they will go and they will search for crystals all over. Sedona's like this vortex. It's like these energy vortexes all over. And this is why people go to Sedona. There's like these hikes that you can go on with different vortexes.
Talking about now we're getting good.
I'm telling you, you will like it. But I would go and get like a guided hike in Sedona, and it's literally like an energy healing kind of capital of the world.
Are you on drugs at all during this hike?
I mean, it depends.
Wait, are you bringing your
own? Are mushrooms drunk?
Yeah.
What are we considering?
Very debatable right now. It's very really debatable.
Sedona's the crystal capital with an asterisk. Yeah. Other things
with an asterisk.
With an asterisk.
Do you bring your own or are they supplied to you in Sedona?
Crystals?
Yes.
Well, I did buy some crystals while I was in Sedona.
Okay.
But there's also, because there's a lot of crystal shops there. I had crystals before though. And different crystals are supposed to have different properties. Apparently there's these like chemical properties in crystals.
Oh, stop the madness.
That help with different functions or different kinds of energies, like whether it's you wanting to be better at speaking your truth or having more self-confidence, or you're trying to heal like sexual trauma, or it just depends on what you're looking for. And they have these whole, like you can go to these crystal shops that literally have, I see this.
I'm listening.
No, I'm invested.
This is one of the things I was skeptical and now I'm officially like, I'm obviously missing something.
I'm actually sold right
well,
now.
And what's interesting though, is like, if you've ever done something called Reiki or energy work, right?
My mom is really into Reiki.
Okay, I like your mom.
Yeah.
Shout out
to
mom.
She's a very spiritually forward person and has been way before.
Love that.
This was cool, yeah.
See, and so Reiki is sort of like an energy work, but it's kind of hard to explain. It's like
hovering over you. Like, you feel my energy, bro.
I almost kind of do.
I'm raking you.
Everything is energy, right? So every person is like made up of, we're all just like vibrating energy. Have you ever done mushrooms? I mean, so if you've ever
on the record or off the record?
Yeah. What are you, a cop? What's going on?
You're talking about the mushroom or you're talking about the chocolate?
Close your ears.
I mean, it's kind of like if you do mushrooms, things come more alive.
Sure.
Like everything is vibrating. Everything, colors vibrate at a different frequency.
Yep.
People, like energies. And so I think that it's, with crystals, they basically vibrate at a certain, because of the molecular structure of the stone or the rock or whatever it's made of, whatever it's comprised of, will have a different kind of vibration that it brings. And you can literally kind of feel it. And, you know, there is something called the placebo effect, which who knows?
Of course.
Who knows?
As long as you're enjoying it, by the way, if the placebo effect works, it's all that matters.
You know, and it's like everything is really mental anyways.
Right.
But it is one of those.
If I got to take a water pill and I trip, then cool. It's cheaper.
But it does, like, different crystals are supposed to have different properties for different purposes. So
So I you're mean, a believer is what you're
I'm
saying.
I'm a believer.
Okay. Hey, all right.
Energy work and crystals, like I'm into
and
it.
Sedona's
we are on the way to get our beginner set of crystals.
I've been low-key right now on TripAdvisor booking a trip to Sedona.
For sure. Not sponsored by a crystal company, but definitely could be sponsored by a crystal company.
Stay at Enchantment Resort. Shout out to Enchantment. I'm not even sponsored. I wish they would, but... That's
Enchantment.
A place.
If there was a resort in Sedona about crystals, it would be called Enchantment.
100%.
Very fitting, right?
My next date, if the person is into crystals, I know where we're going. We should go to Sedona.
Let's go to Sedona.
Honestly, she shouldn't even be into it. You should introduce her to it.
Yeah.
That's the play.
Listen, I'm going to teach you something. Whole world.
This is what I'm talking about.
You want to feel this energy?
YouTube, like what is all of this?
Yeah, 100%. What's to go? All right, we want to give our male listeners a little bit of advice, so we're going to run through some advice
for
you. Okay,
it.
You ready?
Love it.
All right, one top rules for gym etiquette.
Okay, gym etiquette. Don't ever let us catch you filming on your phone. That is so fucking rude.
Got it.
You will possibly. I mean,
like
I'm
filming them.
Filming
or?
You.
Oh,
filming you.
Filming women.
Oh god.
Okay, I can't tell you how many times that's happened where you're just like, bro, are you serious?
Like sneaky.
No
filming?
Shame. Like. Kind of trying to sneak, but you're like, I can literally see you like filming.
Yeah, that's weird.
Guys, okay. Come on, that's ridiculous.
Like,
that's awful.
Get it together.
that was way further down the line. I thought this would be really specific. You know what I mean? Like,
I wasn't even expecting that.
Yeah. I'm just going to send out like a release. Like, can you please like sign this? Like crazy. So there's that. I think the other thing with gym etiquette is if you find a woman attractive, and you're like, I mean, because how many places are you really meeting people, right? It doesn't make you a bad person if you're like, I really want to talk to this girl at the gym. She's really beautiful. I don't know if she's single or not. I would say maybe wait until she's done working out.
Okay.
But don't creepily follow her to the parking lot.
Is she done? She's done? Fuck. No, she's going to the water fountain. Fuck. Cover's blown.
Like,
cover's blown.
Like, don't try to, like, interrupt her or make her take out her headphones at the gym. Like, that's just rude. Like, nobody wants to be interrupted if they're in the middle of a workout. But my biggest thing is, like, read the room a little bit. Like, if she's interested and she finds you hot, she's going to, like, maybe give you some like,
mirror eyes, a little
look at you or smile.
Yeah. Look out for like the body language. If you come around her and she's like suddenly like stiffens up and is like kind of backing away, okay, that's your like sign, go away. Don't try. If she tries to make eye contact with you, then it's like that's maybe like, okay, one point towards a green light. Maybe let's get to three before you approach
three
her.
Points sure. to a
three
green line.
Green lights.
Three
like
green
that.
Lights.
I feel like that's a lot.
Because she will.
It's a lot if of green
like,
lights.
If she's interested, she'll keep kind of like glancing or whatever. So just read the room a little better. If she's like in her zone and like, you know, her boyfriend just walked away, like, no. Please don't.
Yeah.
Okay.
Please do not shoot your shot.
Points to a green light.
That's other gym etiquette is like, we know it's heavy weight and we know that it sometimes takes a groan or two to get it up, but like, please like minimize the sounds because it just comes off as like really intrusive to everybody else's experience that
sure.
in the space. Like
just
it's
the just, massive screams.
Just like,
clinking the plates.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, bro, we get it.
Yeah, hey, like
bro,
dropping the weights. It's yeah. like, come on. Because that's just, it's like very small dick energy actually. You
yeah,
know?
You can't have that.
100%. Yeah, it's
yeah,
like,
yeah. Yeah.
Be a man. Lift it silently.
Yeah. It's BDE, not SDE. We need BDE around here, guys.
Exactly.
Quiet confidence.
Yeah. I would say those are the main ones.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Okay.
Good. Those are good.
What are your biggest red flags in guys in general?
Ooh.
I know you're in a relationship, but in general, what's
oh,
the
yeah.
biggest red flag
oh,
for guys?
I have plenty of red flags I could comment on. Even being in a, I mean, not with him, but
hit him. Tell the people. Tell the people.
So the people, biggest red flags. If you come across as a bullshitter very early on and your words don't match your actions, like, okay, you're full of shit. Like
yeah, sure.
that's gonna be a red flag where you're like, oh yeah, okay, so you're full of shit. There's a lot of salesy, like manipulative. Too many guys have read that book, The Game.
The Game and all the courses.
The
not that
game.
I know what it
how
is.
How do you know what
shut
this
the fuck up.
Is, dude?
Hey guys, this is Drew's last episode on the podcast. Yeah, everyone say
no, I'm just saying because it was like one of those popular things going around back
yes.
then. to where you can kind of manipulate the mindset of women.
It was this book of like how to manipulate women's minds.
No, like a legitimate book. Yeah.
It was like a psychology kind of approach on like how to manipulate women into wanting to fuck you. And
crystals.
Sedona crystals. Take them to Sedona,
panty drop.
Yeah.
So I think one of the main rules is like never be nice to her, or like never be too nice. Like kind of be a dick, like underhandedly like throw out dickish remarks about, oh, well, you wouldn't know anyway. Or, you know, like just a very dick energy.
One of the main things that I read was go up and talk to a girl or initiate conversation. And in the middle of the conversation, without saying anything, break out a pack of gum and offer her a piece. So where now she's thinking in her mind, like, oh my God, does my breath stink?
Yes, so it's like manipulating conversation.
It's weird. Yeah, it's weird. And I was like, this is fucking weird.
Yeah,
I also feel like there's a way different way to handle interactions with females if you're single in age gaps, right? Like there's that when like as you're younger, yeah, way different shit works than when you're like
totally
like your 23-year-old energy and 33-year-old.
And it also depends
energy
on like what are you looking for? Are you looking for like a girl that's kind of stupid? I mean,
this was strictly 19 years old in college.
Are these very vulnerable, gullible chicks that you're just trying to 100% sleep with, or do you want like a woman like that knows her? Because that shit's not going to work on a woman. She's
anyone
gonna, like,
over the
honestly,
age of 25? Not working.
Not working.
Right.
Not working.
It's wild.
This was strictly college.
So there's that where it's like, I mean, if you're looking for a quality person who's going to take you seriously, I shouldn't say quality because it's not that those girls aren't quality. I'm just saying, if you want somebody to take you seriously, don't be an asshole as a tactic to get them to find you more attractive. Like that's just they're going to sniff that out if they're smart. Another red flag, I guess, would be just talking very maliciously about your ex, even if they were a total nightmare. If you're talking there's a difference between being like, here are the facts and this is what she did. This is the bad things that happened and went on. But if you're like, fuck this bitch, blah, cunt, what, that's just like, yo, that's like you have like a hatred that you need to work out still and like heal and go get some crystals.
You need some crystals. I love this fucking podcast.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Crystals solve a lot of problems, guys.
Yeah, for real. So you know. Supplements and crystals.
Like, oh my God.
I don't know what you
need. Kombucha and tequila. Yeah, yeah.
Let's go. Right,
that's the like, starter package for
tequila. Just solve everyone's problems in a short 1 hour span.
Yeah. Yeah.
Gut health, brain health, future, money, done.
Crystals.
Kombucha.
Yeah. It's up.
For real.
I think that would be. Yeah, Melissa.
Those are red flags.
Yeah,
those are some big red flags.
It's actually really good.
Yeah. How long have you been dating your boyfriend now?
We've been together a little over 2 years.
2 years? Yeah. Were you ever on the dating apps prior to him?
I've never been on a dating app.
Really?
Neither have we.
Never been.
These
on
guys
a dating
forced
app.
Me to go on it.
No,
it
was yeah. Have to live through it's funny you. Because like I always tell like I've never been on a dating app, but I'm always like, if I were single, I just happen to like be continually in fucking relationships.
Sure. Nothing. I actually wish I would have been single for longer sometimes.
Right.
Like, but if I would have had a longer period of being single, I think dating apps are brilliant. Like, how else are you going to meet people though? And it's like a way better way to vet people. And
way better.
Like, why? Who wants to waste your time at a dinner date with somebody when you're like, I can
cat guy wrong.
Yeah. Like,
wrong. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Wrong.
I could have sniffed this out very easily in like a message or two. But yeah.
Do your girlfriends, do they use a lot of dating apps? Are they into it?
Yeah, they can be.
Success stories? Nightmare stories?
I have a lot of success stories from girlfriends that have been on dating apps and like literally married and like, it works out.
A couple years ago it was a frowned upon. We've talked about it before. Now it's like, oh, you met in real life? It's crazy. Where'd you guys
at
fucking
the grocery store?
Yeah. Right. Holy shit.
Yeah. That's insane. You know?
I know.
How did you speak to each other? What did you say?
What was your line?
What
did you guys talk about?
No, that's hilarious. Look, these are things that everyone needs to know. All right. So do you live with your boyfriend right now?
Yes.
Okay. So what's the most important thing guys should do when moving in with a girl?
Ooh.
Guys, get your notes ready. Let's go. This is going to be good.
I think, okay. This is actually advice from a couples therapist.
Sure.
I actually have found to be very spot on, is if you have your, okay, designate, obviously some of us live in studio apartments with our significant other, or we have smaller apartments, whatever. As much as you can divide your space and assign a designated space for each person, or at least have like, okay, this bathroom is yours and this bathroom is mine.
like, leave a little mystery and romance to it. Like, don't shit with the door open. Like,
I still haven't pooped in front of my girl. And we've been together 8 years.
I think it's very important.
Very important. And I'm solely convinced she does not poop. I've never witnessed her.
She's like using poopery. Yeah. Just yeah. Like,
there is poopery in our bathroom.
Listen, never. She's a smart woman.
No, is I that think why it's called poopery?
Now I'm married. Slow. What the fuck? Yeah. Poopery?
Not poopery. It's poopery.
It's a brand. No, it's a brand. It's called poopery.
But it's like
literally
little things, right?
No, it's
no, a spray. No. Poopery is a spray. Yeah. It's a brand. It's like wow. It's not sponsored, like, but can be sponsored.
So actually, you know, there's this thing called bedroom divorce. And it was funny because a lot of people who've been married a long time, it's like a big trend now. It's called bedroom divorce.
It's like you
where, yeah, where essentially is that the bedroom becomes like just this place where you're tired and you've had a long day and you're just there to like recover rather than like be with your significant other.
Totally.
And so, and people think it's odd because we're conditioned to be like, when you get married, or you live with someone, you have a bedroom, you sleep together for the rest of your lives, and then you die, right?
Right.
And this is called bedroom divorce, where you just have two separate rooms now.
Two separate rooms.
And you have an area where you go when you want it to be like something special.
Totally.
And then you have your separate areas when you're just like, I'm dead. I don't want to talk to you. Like, whatever. Like, I'm totally going to sleep or whatever it may be.
I think that's the biggest thing is, like, people need their own space. It doesn't, like, if people were just able to have their own, like, space and they gave each other a chance to breathe. I'm big also on, like, I travel a lot. I, for my own sanity, I'm like, I need to get out of town. I go and, like, I work. I go and I have trips with my girlfriends. I have, like, and we have come to an agreement with each other of, like, we both need time to be our own person.
Huge.
You cannot just be this enmeshed like blob that just has no identity anymore, because you're going to end up miserable and you're going to like start resenting each other and you're going to feel like a shell of your old self. And then that's when you start romanticizing your single days, right? Mm. So if you can keep there's like mystery and a little bit of that separation of like, I'm an individual, you're an individual. We have like this, there's a boundary here. Like you have to have some healthy boundaries, and it's not because I don't want to be around you. It's because I actually give a fuck about this relationship and I want to make sure that this lasts and that we're not going to sabotage it. Because I think if you get too enmeshed, it's just not good for anybody.
Yeah, you need an identity.
I feel like we need to write that down and that's trademark right that last paragraph you just said, and like sure bundle it up and like sell it. That was fantastic.
Well, and even just like with romance.
Sure.
Like, you can't keep the magic alive or be turned on constantly by each other with your like shitting in front of each other.
100%.
Plus, look, time has a lot to do with it, right? Like 2 years and 3 years and 5 years and 8 years. Like,
Jeff's a big shitter in front of his wife, by the way.
Yeah, well by the way.
He's like, fuck you.
They thought I was crazy and I never done
we're
it.
Authentic.
Yeah. We're authentic. We're authentic,
God damn it. Yeah. My wife and I, we're about to be married for 5 years. We've been together for a long time. And I think time, even outside of all of that, right, is like the spontaneity and things that have come closer, you have to like start thinking about things that used to come so natural and easy.
Like put effort into
it. Yeah,
no joke. Set a date, like a date night is like an old concept, but it's like super brilliant.
Huge.
Well, we also now have a child, so which makes things 100,000 times
better. Totally. And it's like, get dressed up. Like that was one thing, I work from home. I'm like, we need to actually go get dressed up and go out. Because like when I'm traveling, I'll do that. But when I'm at home, I'm kind of like, meh.
Sweatpants.
And like, it's like, no.
Sweatpants. Postmates. Yeah. Let's do this.
100%. Every single night.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Spandex all day. It's like, you know, trying to put that effort in. Because you're going to fall in love with different versions of each other all the time. But it's like, keep courting each other, I guess. And keep some of the mystery. And like, some mystery is like adds a little sexiness.
Of course,
to
sure,
it too.
Sure.
So
I think. Well, by the way, it seems like you guys are going to do really well since it seems like you really give a shit about trying to make it work, right? Some people are pretty lazy about that.
Well, thank you.
Which is so.
He's pretty awesome.
We'll do a follow up podcast in another year.
So. Yeah. He's like,
see what happens. See what kind of crystals you guys are rocking then. Yeah. Speaking of your boyfriend, by the way, he's a fighter.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You are physically fit, obviously active. I see you on Instagram doing a little kickboxing. Mm-hmm. Would you ever fight?
You know, it's funny. I actually got I got an offer for like a little celebrity / influencer, whatever, boxing match like in July. Mm. But they gave me a month's notice. And I was like, because I've trained for years, mostly kickboxing, not like technical boxing. So I was like, oh, like I would need a little more training for just boxing specific. And like, I never really wanted to get into the ring, but I was like, the money was good. And I'm like,
I could probably scrap and fuck a bitch up.
Boxing gloves.
Yeah, we're doing this.
It's good money. So I was like really thinking about it for a second. And now I've just been a little more consistent because I was like, well, maybe put me in for the next one. It is one of those things, like if it's a celebrity or influencer or whatever boxing match, you are wearing headgear. Sure. So it's not like... It's
amateur match, yeah.
But I'm also like, my nose. Maybe that would just give me a free nose job, I guess.
Give me a reason.
We just never know. Like my attitude was like, I spend way too much money on Botox and upkeep to like go get fucked up in a ring.
You seem pretty competitive though, and someone who would like want the accomplishment of winning.
Oh, I would. I would train hard and I would like go in.
Because that's really all it is. Like the money might be good, but you can make money elsewhere.
She's like, I'm already training just in case it comes back up.
No, yeah, that's I mean. Like, I up my training. I'm like 3 times a week. Like, and what's nice is like Chris trains me and he can train me, you know, it's nice. We can literally do it in the living room. But maybe. So the answer is maybe.
There we go.
It is like
no breaking news, guys. Sorry. Zero breaking
ready
news.
Just in case there's another offer.
Yeah. It would be like a fun new way of like challenging myself too, of just because like my cardio sucks and I have so much respect for fighters and just the cardio and the athletic abilities to just perform at that level where I'm like, that would be a really cool way to, maybe that's sort of another reinvention of myself and evolution of the brands. I don't know. We'll see.
But we'll watch.
Yeah.
Would you guys come?
We'll come.
I would be charging my crystals for you.
Yeah, yeah, bring crystals with us.
Be like meditating on crystals before it, please. So that
I would drink some kombucha. I would actually hope that you tell the company that you have the perfect ringside announcers for this fight.
Yeah. Hey.
For sure.
Because
I saw that.
I think we're born for that.
The ultimate announcer was on your podcast the other day. That was
cool. Yeah. Bruce Buffer. Yeah.
Did he do the voice? I didn't get to listen to that one. Yeah, like he's just like, him talking.
He comes in and out. He came in.
It's time.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he's the man.
He's a legend.
We'll let him do the announcing in the middle. We want to be like the play-by-play announcer in the sideline.
Yeah. Listen,
She just punched that bitch in the face. You saw that, guys? Yeah. Oh man.
Yeah, we'll be your hype train. That'll be fun. For
sure. I'm down.
All right, another controversial question.
Yes.
Food wise.
Oh.
Best fast food chains for cheat meals.
Ooh. You know. I like Chick-fil-A.
Okay.
Like, because, this is super nerdy. As like, but as a trainer, it's like, there's some, if you get like a grilled chicken, you know, Chick-fil-A thing.
That's not cheap meal.
But that's not a cheap meal.
That's not cheap meal.
Yeah. That's a meal.
When no one's watching.
You're hacking fast food to be held up. Yeah. That wasn't the question.
Yeah. Number one, no holds barred.
Chick-fil-A, get the grilled
chicken.
I mean,
for
me,
for you.
When
for
I'm
you.
Trying to just get dirty
your opinion.
Cheating.
Your opinion.
I love a Shake Shack burger for some reason. Wow. I love an In-N-Out burger.
Okay.
I don't like their fries though. Here. Like In-N-Out, what is up with your fries? Like you need to like fix that shit.
Apparently, Alexa Bliss from WWE was on our show.
Oh, I listened to that one.
Amazing.
She was great.
Her secret was you have to get them half crispy, half well done, half regular.
Put them in a bag and shake them up.
And by the way, we had thousands of comments on our social media about this. Apparently, you could also go and just order them light well, which is just ordering French fries that are in between. So you can order them French fries
at In-N-Out. Really?
I'd like an order of fry.
Light well. That's like a little more.
I didn't know
well
you
done.
Could customize.
Pretty
this.
Fucking nerdy and out there. I like
oh
that.
Oh my god, yeah. I like that.
Shout out Alexa Bliss. Yeah. That was great.
And shout out everybody that commented. Light well. We get it.
That caused a serious stir on the internet.
Brilliant.
Don't talk about French fries, or you're gonna get the smoke on TikTok.
And you said Shake Shack before In-N-Out. People are gonna get pissed.
Smoke
I
on
know.
TikTok.
Listen. Have you tried Shake Shack lately? It's pretty good.
Shake Shack is fire.
Shake Shack is fire. It's but great. I just think the price difference between In-N-Out, the quality you're getting, and the customizations of an In-N-Out burger, if you order it the way I tell you to order it, it does not compare.
So there's more customizations beyond the light well.
There's a whole secret menu.
Yeah. Would you like to hear my order?
Yeah, I would like to hear it.
Of Shake Shack? No, In-N-Out. No.
He's such an In-N-Out. It's
roll the window down. Say hi. Welcome to the In-N-Out Burger. They always ask, how's your day? You know, my day's fucking fantastic. How's yours?
They always respond, oh, it's great. What can I get for you? Well, Samantha, you can absolutely get me a number one, which is the double-double. I want the bun extra toasted, animal style, which is extra spread, mustard grill patty, pickles. We're going to add chopped chilies. I'm also going to sub out the grilled chopped onions for grilled whole onions. Let's get a little freaky with it, okay? If you want to get a little wild, you get the animal style fries, nice little iced tea or shake, whatever you want.
Let me ask
the order.
Wow.
That is like a cheat meal done well.
Oh, that's cheat meal on steroids.
It's also like a food coma.
You're kind of now. Like,
the chopped chilies is the one.
Smash chopped chilies.
Chopped chilies is the one. Chopped chilies is the one. That is the order.
Chopped chilies.
Add chopped chilies.
If you ask for chilies, they give you the little packets. No, you want them chopped on your burger.
In the burger.
Oh, wow. And they'll go for, they'll do that?
Oh,
do
with a smile on their face.
Yeah.
They'll do that?
They won't even ask questions.
You're an In-N-Out legend.
They won't even ask questions.
I love that, like, the customer service is really what he's so happy.
They might even throw in a fist bump at
the end. That makes a big difference.
But listen, this is why brands, certain brands do really fucking well, is because they have drilled that into their employees. I love it.
It's like Chick-fil-A in the service. Like, oh, I could go to this restaurant, or even though this car has 100 more cars in line,
Chick-fil-A will be the fastest. My pleasure.
They'll be sprinting after you, washing your car, putting air in your tires.
Unless it's a Sunday.
And then it's
dead.
Quiet.
It will be dead.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, alternate fuck you, we're going to church.
Absolutely. Well, guys, all weekend we're going to be drinking, we're going to be eating In-N-Out, taking supplements, holding on to crystals.
Drinking kombucha.
Yeah, this was an amazing show. Thank you for coming on. We appreciate you. Have fun in Las Vegas.
So fun.
Guys, make sure to follow her on Instagram. Check out the supplements. We want it all. Anything else you want to tell the world?
Hey, come by, say hi.
Yeah, that's exactly. Guys, we appreciate you. We'll see you next week.